In this video, I'll show you how to use a range of Logos features to use layouts to organize your workspaces, store links to key pieces of information, capture and annotate information you find, export and cite your research using a range of formatting options, add a link to layouts to your home page. Guides and tools that can be used to study one topic can clearly be used to research others as well. So saving useful configurations as layouts can be really helpful. Move panels around so you get the exact layout you want. Close any you don't want to include. Then click the Layouts menu. Click Save as Named Layout and give the layout a name. Then anytime you want to go back to it, find it in the list of saved layouts and click it. Favorites are a good way of keeping links to resources and features you want to access later. Click the Tools menu, type FAV in the search box, and click Favorites. Click the New Folder button, overwrite the name, and drag the folder to where you want it. Create another new folder called Baptism, and drag it over the Topics folder to create a subfolder. Then drag things into this folder, such as the Factbook tool, the topic guide, the search panel, and open resource. And please note that favorites save links to the actual locations in resources, the search details, etc. So you can close the Factbook tool, then click the favorite links for it to open it to a new panel. One of the simplest ways of capturing and citing information is by copying it to an external word processor. Select some text in a resource, copy it, I'm using Control C for this, and then paste it into a word processor document. A footnote is automatically created. Citation formatting is controlled from Program Settings and the Citation Style option. You can also control whether citations are copied at all, and whether they are hyperlinked back to the resources. Now pause the video for a while and spend some time experimenting with different citation styles to determine which works best for you. Another powerful capability for capturing research ideas is the use of clippings. These are designed to allow you to clip articles or details you want to be able to easily access and reference later. Open the Docs menu, click New and Clippings. Give the clippings document a name. Now select some text you want to clip, right-click, ensure that the text is selected on the right, and click Add a Clipping. The selected text will be copied to the clipping, as will bibliographic information. Choose the citation style you want by selecting it from the drop-down menu. Then click the Copy button and paste the results into the Bibliography section of your word processing document. Click the arrow at the bottom right to get back to the clipping itself. Even if the clipped resource is closed, clicking the link at the top left will open it to the correct place. Select another article in another resource and add it to the clippings file. This enables you to build up a reference of key articles for the topic you are studying. Drag the clippings document to the Favorites folder to ensure you retain easy access to it. Another way of capturing information with the option of marking up resources is to use notes. Open the Tools menu, select the Notes tool. Select some text in a resource, right-click, and add a note. To expand the note area, click the Expand button. Like clippings, this provides a link to get back to the article. To add some comments to your note, type in the Take a Note area. By default, this marks up the text to show a note has been taken, and hovering over the icon displays the note. You can also highlight the text as a reminder that it was referenced. For more details of the use of notes and highlights, please see other Faith Life training videos. Both clippings and notes are really powerful ways of capturing and organizing research. Notes are particularly useful if you want to add comments and mark up the resource in some way. Clippings are useful when you want to record information, but not to mark up the text at all. Ideally, citations include page numbers. While, as we've seen, these are generated automatically, it is possible to display page numbers within the resource itself. Click the Resource Filter menu, open the Resources section, and select Show Page Numbers. Logos now displays the start of each page with associated number in the resource itself. But please note that not all resources in Logos include page numbers. In those cases, different citation guidelines need to be followed. In most research papers, a bibliography of resources cited is required. To create one, open the Docs menu, click New, and select Bibliography. Items can be added to this document from a range of sources. To add in information from the Clippings document, click A Clippings Document and choose the clipping on baptism. To add an item for a particular resource, select some text in the resource, open the Add drop-down in the Bibliography document and click Selected Text. Pause the video and experiment with some of the other options. And remember to set the formatting style as required. To update your layout to incorporate these extra items, click the Layouts menu and click Update Active. Close all panels to clear your workspace down. To be able to open the layout directly from the home page, switch to the home page and click the plus button on the dashboard. Click Layout and find the layout you created. Select it and click Add. This adds a card to your home page. Click it to open the layout to enable you to continue your study where you left off. This combination of tools, features, and the ability to organise your workspace to your own requirements provides a very powerful platform on which to study and record your findings. And as you've seen, Logos also provides a range of flexible and customizable mechanisms to export and cite your research in the format you need. Remember to ensure the citation style you're using is the most appropriate for the work you are doing.